From cherry cola and lemonade to a rainbow of bright liqueurs, color affects how we experience our favorite drinks in surprising ways. Color also offers a great lens by which to experience the art behind the science of beverage development. In the US, the Federal Drug Administration serves as the primary governing body for approving the color additives used in beverages. According to the FDA, a color additive may include both substances derived from natural and synthetic substances, and any ingredient added for color must be disclosed on the ingredient's statement. Naturally positioned color additives are those derived from such sources such as vegetables, fruits, minerals, or animals. Two of the most common naturally positioned colors are caramel color and specially formulated fruit and vegetable juice blends. Of course, there are also artificial colors. fd&c numbers are assigned to synthetically created color additives tested and certified by the FDA. Surprisingly, there are only 4 certified color additives approved by the FDA for use in beverages: blue number 1, red number 40, yellow number 5, and yellow number 6. The major differences between naturally positioned color additives and synthetic fd&c colors involve stability and longevity. Let's take a closer look at how they work in practice.
Artificial colors can be used to make any shade you can imagine. For example, using only artificial colors, I can turn this drink base bright green. I'll just add yellow and blue together, little by little, until I get the desired color. The same method applies to any other color you can think of. I'll just use different primary colors with different dilutions to create them. Purple, dark red, and orange all look great.
If your beverage concept is naturally positioned, you'll most likely be using something like a blend of fruit and vegetable juices. These will give you a range of reds, pinks, yellows, and oranges to work with, but there are limitations.
Making a dark red with naturally derived colors isn't a problem, but you couldn't make bright green like we did before. That's because if I add blueberry juice to our drink base, it will turn orange or red due to a chemical reaction caused by the acidity of the drink. Since I can't have a naturally sourced blue color, I can't make green. Though this is a disadvantage of naturally derived colors, many health-focused consumers are becoming more attracted to beverages with no added colors on the label. Avoiding color additives altogether is a good way to prevent color-related formulation challenges and save on your per-unit ingredient costs.
Color stability and longevity is the other main area where color additives show their differences. Naturally occurring color additives tend to change or fade quickly in a product, especially when used with ingredients like vitamin C. Depending on the type of packaging, products with naturally occurring colors can experience changes within as little as 6 months. Compare that to artificial colors, which regularly hold up for a year or more. Finding the right color additives for your custom formulated product may be a challenge, but it's one that the beverage development experts at Flavorman can assist with. To discover how our team can help you change what the world is drinking, visit flavorman.com. And don't forget to keep in touch by following us on social media.